So in this video, we'll see how to use a parameterized constructor. So you can see we have int I. So in order to call that int I, we need to pass something. So if you pass 5, it will call this ABC with a parameter. So if I run this now, even if I'm passing that 5, we are not actually using it. But the only reason I'm using that 5 is to call this parameterized constructor. Because if you remove that 5, you can see we're getting an error. It says we don't have any constructor with a default parameter. But hold on, in the earlier example or in any example, we have never used constructor, right? We have never defined this constructor. Because when you define a parameterized constructor, that means you should also define a default constructor. Since we are not writing default constructor, we have to pass this 5. So if I run this, and the output is in abc const. But can I have two constructors with the same name? Obviously, we can write public abc, and this constructor is not accepting any parameter. So what we'll do is we'll say in abc const para, and somewhere here we'll say in abc const, right? So we are writing here in abc const para, and here in abc const, if I pass this 5, obviously it will call this one. But what if I don't pass any value? So this time it will call in const, in abc const. So this thing we have two constructors with the same name but different parameters, this concept is called as constructor. So this is constructor overloading. So this is constructor, and when you have two constructors with the same name and different parameter, which is called as constructor overloading. Even we can define any number of constructors here. So we can say int abc, and this will accept int I, comma, let's say double d. So we can have a constructor with two parameters. We can have a constructor with three parameters. And we'll say here in abc const int double. So since we have two things, we'll say int double. And since we have two parameters, we need to pass those two parameters. We'll say 6, comma, 5.5. Right. So if I run this code now, it will call it will call the constructor with two parameters, right? So that's why it is int double. Clear? So this is what we have, a concept of constructor overloading. So in the next video, we'll talk about more about this constructor parameters.